Jennifer from Scrapping Under the Influence. So I am back with another Halloween project. We're just about done with all of our 13 Frights Before Halloween. This one is super, super simple. So this is just a tumbler from Michael's. I used the Cricut Smart Vinyl for the, permanent Smart Vinyl for the Joy to cut out this fun little quote from Hocus Pocus. And we are going to put this on to this little tumbler. So before I do that, I'm going to take just some rubbing alcohol and I'm going to clean the outside of my tumbler. Okay. That's just going to get any oils from my skin or anything like that off of the tumbler itself. I'm going to get my transfer tape ready. So doing vinyl on a curved surface is a little bit trickier. I have done it, it's been a couple of years, but I've made a whole bunch of tumblers for some friends for table gifts at a retreat a few years ago that I did their names on them, and like my test one was actually a Halloween one. Okay, so I'm going to get the one more time. Well, this is such tiny letters, it's not wanting to. Okay, that was interesting. It's not wanting to stick to the transfer tape. And this may be in part because this is that kind of shimmery vinyl. Yeah, I think I need my, the other kind. I think I need the strong grip. Give me one second. Put that back. I have a piece of that. Ah, right there. I knew I had some. I don't like the strong grip typically. I've always had a really hard time with it as far as like getting the vinyl off of the transfer tape. But in this case, because of the finish on this vinyl, this is absolutely what we need to use. So far, so good. The O's on here are just not cooperating. I was having a hard time even when I was weeding. The O's just did not want to. And of course, that bottom on that M is going to fight with us too. Here we go. Ha! There we go. Okay, so doing curved surfaces. And I'm actually going to get sitting where it's not going to move. Actually, I'm going to take a lid out of that because that's just going to make me think I'm off kilter when I'm not. Okay, so I'm going to start in the middle. And just very carefully burnish that down. And then just work out from the center. Okay. This section up here is a little bit easier because the bottom part of it here, we are getting more of a curve. Probably could have gone up another quarter of an inch and not had an issue, but it's okay because we will make it work. Okay. burnishing that down. And then I'm going letter by letter on this bottom section, which really, I could have done that whole bottom line of this separately, and that would have made it that much easier. But I've found it easier when I've done these to do it all at once, and you don't have to worry about that line, the separate line going on straight. So, pulling the transfer tape off very, very carefully, and I'm doing it, hopefully you can kind of tell, I'm doing it kind of flat, so I'm not like lifting and pulling. I'm putting it so it's like peeling straight back. And this way, it's not pulling up on the vinyl as you're peeling it off. Make sure everything's down, and there you go. Perfect, ready to go. This will be for my wine in the hot tub, occasionally the cold brew in the morning, you never know. And I actually meant to get that little dot on that eye out because it was in a weird spot and I didn't like it. So, oh look, another glorious morning makes me sick. Awesome. There you go, super fast, super easy, and we're just about done with our Halloween projects, so I hope you will join me for my last project next Monday. Thanks, guys. See you next week.